With Pulumi, bringing a Docker container from development into production in AWS Fargate is just a few lines of TypeScript. In this video, we'll show you how. If you haven't installed Pulumi or provided access to your AWS credentials yet, now is a good time to do that. First, we'll need to create a new Pulumi project. This can be done using the Pulumi CLI in the terminal. We'll create a new project using the AWS TypeScript template and follow the prompts. We'll use the default dev stack and specify our desired AWS region. We'll be using US East 1. This example uses a Docker file located in a folder named app. For this video, let's copy over an existing Python application. Now we're ready to open the index.ts file and start building our Pulumi program. The AWS TypeScript template produces a Pulumi program in the index.ts that will demonstrate creating an S3 bucket. We won't be using S3, so we'll delete that and replace it with our code. We'll start by provisioning an entire Elastic Container Service, or ECS, cluster. This is AWS's native container orchestration technology. We can do that with a single line of code. And we'll name it cluster. This will use the default virtual private cloud or VPC in your account. This is easily customizable by passing the appropriate arguments. But for this example, the defaults will work. Now on to defining the networking. First, we'll create a load balancer. This will give us a fixed address while allowing us to create a scaled out application. We'll use the AWS package to create an Elastic Application Load Balancer, or ALB in AWS. It's a fully featured layer 7 load balancer. We'll give it the name netlb, set it to external, and use the cluster we just created to set the security groups. Now we want to expose port 80 to the internet and listen for incoming traffic. This can be done by adding a listener to the load balancer we just created. We'll name it web, listen to port 80, and set it to external. Now it's time to build and publish the container defined in the app folder. Thanks to the AWS X package, we can accomplish this with just a single line of code. This single line will allocate a private Elastic Container Registry, or ECR, repository for your Docker image. This is AWS's hosted Docker registry solution, privately encapsulated inside your AWS account. It will also build the Docker file in the app directory and publish it to the registry each time you run Pulumi up. This means you get a single command line to both provision and update your infrastructure, in addition to publishing and rolling out your images. Next up, let's deploy our published image as a containerized service behind our load balanced network on port 80 using our ECS cluster. We'll do this by creating an AWS Fargate service. Fargate is a managed container orchestrator that lets us skip the messy details of installing and managing Swarm on our own. We'll name it app service and pass references to the cluster, image, and listener we created above. Pulumi tracks all the dependencies so it knows how to perform deployment activities in the right order. Now we're ready to deploy the application, but first let's add one last line of code that exposes the load balancer address so it's easy to access. This will create a Pulumi stack output named URL, which will be displayed in the Pulumi up stack output and in your project in app.pulumi.com. Now let's switch to the terminal window and deploy the application by running Pulumi up. First, we are presented with a preview of all the resources that will be created. Selecting yes will deploy everything to your AWS account. We now have a fully functioning application. Let's give it a try. First, we can simply curl it using the Pulumi CLI to access our URL stack output. We can also open it in a browser. Now if we go back to the terminal and open the permalink, we can see a history of our deployments similarly to how Git works with GitHub. You can also see all of your resources and outputs. We now have a fully functioning AWS microservice, including the infrastructure and application resources. All it took was a Docker file and a few lines of TypeScript. No YAML, complex sequence of CLI commands, or manual cluster installation was required.